This demonstration video will show the steps to set up an SRH-2D simulation in SMS, link components to the simulation, set up model control parameters, and run the model. We have opened an SMS project of our demo site. This site is a bridge crossing over the Cimarron River in Oklahoma. This is the same site used in the exercise for Lesson 1. The first step is to create a simulation. This is done by right-clicking in the Project Explorer and selecting the command New Simulation, SRH-2D. Notice a new simulation data item appears in the Project Explorer. The default name for the simulation is Sim. The simulation name can be changed by right-clicking on the simulation and selecting Rename. For this project, we will rename it to Cimarron 100 Year. We will now assemble the components for the simulation. Remember, for this lesson, the mesh and all other components have already been created in the project. We will show how to create these in later lessons. We will first link the mesh by clicking and dragging it until the solid black line appears beneath the simulation name. Release the mouse button to link it to the simulation. Remember to link the mesh, not the mesh generator coverage. We will also need to link the other components. These are called coverages in SMS. We will link the BC, materials, and monitor coverages. Next, we'll link the BC coverage. Another way to link coverages is to right-click on the coverage and select Apply to SRH-2D Simulations, Cimarron 100 Year. We will also do this for the materials coverage. For the monitor coverage, let's go back to linking by dragging and dropping again. We will now have created the simulation and linked the four components we need to run the model. Before we run the model, we need to set the model control parameters. Right-click on the simulation and select Model Control. Here in the General tab, you can add a description and a unique case name if desired. We'll skip that for this demo. We'll now set the time parameters. Let's leave the start time at 0, set the time step to 5 seconds, and the end time to 3 hours. For the initial condition, we usually select dry or automatic. For this demo, let's leave it as dry. Finally, we will set the output parameters here on the output tab. For the output method, we often use a specified frequency. We could also just have it output the solution at the simulation end. We will select specified frequency and enter 15 minutes as the output frequency. Leave the output format as XMDF and change the units to English. The simulation is now ready to run. To do this, we right-click on the simulation and select Save Project Simulation and Run. This will save the model and start the model run. It will take a few moments to save the model data and initiate the model run, which will launch the Simulation Run Queue dialog. At the top, notice these three progress bars for the run. First, the pre-SRH-2D process runs, which sets up the model. Once that finishes, the SRH-2D process begins. By selecting the SRH-2D process, the tabs for the various plots will appear. The plots cannot be viewed without selecting this process. These plots can be reviewed while the model runs. For now, we will look at the Monitor Points Plot tab. This plot shows the water surface elevation of the monitor points created. This plot in particular is useful to monitor the progress of the run, to see when steady state is reached for a model. Once these curves flatten out, it means the model elevations have reached equilibrium. There are several other plots that can be viewed in this dialog during the model run, including plotting the values of the flows across the monitor lines. The details of all these plots will be discussed in a later lesson. Once this third post-SRH-2D process is complete, select the Load Solution button. This will load the model solution into SMS. Note a new group of solution datasets appears under the mesh data in the Project Explorer. Here you can select the solution datasets you would like to view. Let's select the velocity magnitude. You can see the solution covers only part of the domain. This is because we are viewing the initial time step. Let's use the arrow keys on the keyboard to toggle through the time steps until we get to the last time step. This shows the solution at the end of the simulation. At this point, we could select other time steps or change our display options to view our model results. For example, we could turn off the elements to better view the solution. This concludes our demonstration for setting up and running an SRH-2D simulation in SMS. The exercise that follows will give you additional information and practice.